गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर चैप्टर नंबर 3 ऑफ बायो, रिप्रोडक्शन इन एनिमल्स। स्टूडेंट्स, रिप्रोडक्शन इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ऑल द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, लाइक प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स ऑल्सो रिप्रोड्यूस। दे रिप्रोड्यूस यंग वंस ऑफ देयर ओन काइंड। ओके सो स्टूडेंट्स, द प्रोसेस बाय विच लिविंग बींग्स गिव बर्थ टू देयर यंग वंस ऑफ देयर ओन काइंड, ओके, टू मेंटेन एंड कंटिन्यू देयर स्पीशीज, दैट इज कॉल्ड वॉट? रिप्रोडक्शन। स्टूडेंट्स, रिप्रोडक्शन इन एनिमल्स, रिप्रोडक्शन अकर्स इन टू वेज, एसेक्चुअली एंड सेक्चुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द एसेक्चुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। इन दिस रिप्रोडक्शन स्टूडेंट्स, ओनली वन इंडिविजुअल, वन पेरेंट इज नीडेड। इट डज नॉट इन्वॉल्व द फ्यूजन ऑफ सेक्स सेल्स, दैट मीन्स ऑफ गैमेट्स, and it occurs in the lower organisms like amoeba, hydra, starfish. So what are the common methods of this reproduction? Let's see. First is fission. In this method, students, of asexual reproduction, single celled organism divides into two daughter cells. Okay, like this, I'll show you here, like this. Okay, it divides into two cells like this. Okay, let's see now. So the cell divides equally along with the cytoplasm, equal cytoplasm and the nucleus. Okay, this we can see in amoeba, paramecium, like this. When the cell divides into two daughter cells, student, the division is called what? Binary fission. During unfavorable condition, students, some organisms develop a thick protective cover. What is that called? That is called cyst. Inside that cyst, the cell divides rapidly along with the nucleus. When the favorable conditions come, what happens? The cyst ruptures and releases many daughter cells. And this is called what? Multiple fission. This happens in what? Plasmodium. What is that plasmodium? A vector of what? Malaria. Let's see here. In this diagram, binary fission here in the amoeba and here producing the cyst. Okay, producing the cyst here. When the favorable conditions comes, the cyst ruptures and what happens? These all daughter cells come out. Okay, this is what called multiple fission. Now students, budding. In this method of asexual reproduction, students, due to accumulation of cytoplasm, what happens? An outgrowth appears. That outgrowth is known as bud. Okay, and what happens? It gets detached later to lead an independent existence. Like this, it happens in the hydra. Like this, here, this outgrowth. After some time, what happens? This outgrowth detaches from the parent and it lives independent. Okay, budding also takes place, students, in sponges also. Okay. Now regeneration. Students, in regeneration, what happens? If a part of body get detached or cut due to the accident or injury from the parent's body, it can regrow, students, and develop into completely new individual. Okay, it is carried out by the multiplication of special cells which undergo student changes and form similar types of cells and tissues also. Okay, like the original hydra, flatworm, starfish and earthworm, these all are capable of regenerating their lost parts, students. Okay, now come to the fragmentation. Students, in fragmentation, the parent body breaks into the distinct pieces where each piece regrows and develops into mature offsprings. Okay, it happens in the flatworms. Like this, as you are seeing, one parent, it divides into three parts here in this diagram and each three parts develops into a new organism. Now students, we will talk about the sexual reproduction. Students, like flowering plants, in all the multicellular and higher organisms, sexual reproduction takes place. The process of sexual reproduction involves what? Male and female gamete. Okay, now what happens, student? Male gamete produces sperm and the female gamete produces what? Ovum. When the sperm fuses with the ovum, students, a zygote is formed, which develops into what? Into embryo. The embryo after afterwards it changes into a new organism. In different animals, student, development of embryo takes place by the following different methods. Students, in some animals, what happens, such as birds and reptiles, the embryo grows outside the mother's body in a hard-shelled egg. The egg hatches after some time and young one comes out of it. In fishes and amphibians, the embryo develops inside the mother's body. Okay, but it delivers its drives its nutrients from the egg yolk. In higher animals, students, cow, dogs, human beings, embryo develops within the mother's body for a considerable time period and drives nourishment from the mother's body through an umbilical cord. Now, students, we will study about the sexual reproduction in human beings. Students, human beings are the most complex and highly developed animals. In human beings, the reproductive cells are produced in a definite organs. What is that called? That is called gonads. Students, in a man, these organs are called testes, which produce sperms. Okay. And in women, these organs are called what? Ovaries, which produces what? Ova. Now let's see the read about the reproductive female reproductive system. Students, it consists of following parts. First, ovaries. Students, these are two whitish colored oval bodies which is located in the abdominal cavity. Inside each ovary, student, there are groups of cells. What is that called? They are called follicles. One mature egg, students, it develops, begins to develop after every 4 weeks. Okay, alternatively in these follicles. Now, oviduct, these are funnel-shaped muscular tubes which are present in each ovary and they are called fallopian tubes also. Okay, it passes the egg into the uterus. Let's see the diagram, students. Here, ovary is there, oviduct, or we can say fallopian tubes are there, uterus is there. Let's see, uterus wall is there, cervix and then vagina. Now, let's see the uterus. It is a thick-walled, student, spear-shaped muscular hollow organ. Okay, it lies in the lower abdomen behind and above the urinary bladder. The uterus narrows down and into a small opening that is called cervix. Now, students, vagina, it is a wide muscular tube which receives the sperms and it also serves as the birth canal through which the mature baby is delivered. Now, let's see the function, students. Each ovary, student, produces eggs and two hormones, estrogen and progesterone, okay, which is responsible for the changes in the body during puberty. Now, oviduct, it is a tube that serves as a pathway for an egg from ovary to the uterus. Okay, students, uterus, it serves as a room for developing embryo. Okay, cervix, it's the lower part of the uterus that opens outside through the vagina. And vagina, it receives the sperms. Okay, and it is a also serves as the birth canal. Okay, for the mature baby to be delivered. Now, students, the ovulation and the menstruation. After attaining the puberty in females, student, one mature egg is released every 28th day on an average. This is what called ovulation, and the 28th day cycle is known as menstrual cycle. Before the release of the egg, students, the inner wall of the uterus gets thickened with the increased supply of blood to receive the fertilized egg. If the egg is not fertilized, students, the inner layer of the uterus, that is called endometrium, it breaks down and the blood along with the tissues is discharged from the vagina. Okay, this flow of blood is known as menstruation and it lasts, students, for 2 to 5, 3 to 5 days. Okay, students. Now, ovulation and menstruation in human females. Here it's the diagram, students. Okay. After attaining puberty, one egg get matured after 28 to 30 days each month. That is called ovulation. Here, okay, the matured egg is released from one of the ovaries. Then the inner layer of the uterus get thickened, okay, with the supply of blood. And if the egg is not fertilized, what happens? A blood comes out from the vagina, that is called menstruation. Okay, students, for today, up till here, we will continue in the next video. Thank you.